Yeah, you suck. Show 98 Intensity continues. I am here with the hybrid champion, Big C.
Hello, how
and
you
I'm
doing?
Joined by current supreme champion, Bouncer. I have a lot of gold around me.
Right.
You know, my fucking bling wow. Yo, first, before we get into this backyard tailor-made, how you guys like my match today?
It was.
Oh, it's not a bad match. I mean, good, like man. I said before, you're a little rusty, but that's all right.
Yeah, suck my dick.
You know,
yeah.
No, I would not suck your dick, but it was a good match. It was a good match. You brought it back. You brought it with some. Elbows, man. Them elbows was crazy.
Yeah, man.
I like them elbows. You were throwing
dropping
them
bow.
Them bows.
Two bones.
Right. So I'll give you that. Yeah. All right, it was a good match. So
yeah, my heterosexual soulmate there, Backyard, is in the ring with great up-and-comer Taylor Made. And it'd be really cool if both of us Southside players could win today. Oh, damn.
It would. It would be nice.
But, I mean, Taylor's a tough guy to root against because you just like him so much. He's such a good guy and a great wrestler and a huge star here in WMWA.
I hate that move, I swear. I don't even know what to call that move. I hate that move. But then, you know, it's crazy. I wonder what he's going to do when he catches somebody that actually enjoys that type of thing.
Angel?
Right.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll have a first in-ring ejaculation.
There's a first for everything.
Right, there's a first for everything. You're correct on that.
I hope I'm wrong on that part, but man, it's good to be, you know, back in the locker room with you boys, you know what I mean? I mean, not the Sandusky way, but I'm talking about like just, you know, being one of your peers again, you know, not the commissioner, not the commentator. It's a good feeling, man. It's been 14 months, been out of there.
I'm glad to see you back.
Yeah, man, I'm glad to be back, man. Just in time for the 100th show. We all got, you know, big plans coming up. More matches, from my understanding, Commissioner Asnell is on an important business meeting today.
Right.
Won't be here, but it involves the 100th show, so we might find out next week some more stuff. But more matches will be made today. I got an in-ring blockbuster announcement later.
I can't wait to hear
that. Yeah, man. And Taylor Made versus CJ Price. Both these guys know their opponents. Backer's going to wrestle Anarchy in a casket match. Sidewalk slam!
Big
Beast sidewalk. Mode!
I'm looking forward to that show.
Taylor, Beast Mode on!
I know that show's gonna be a real big show. I know we're gonna
the
really
biggest
have
of all time. We've been you and me, see, we've been here since the start. We've been a part of some big ones, the first ever Genesis,
right?
Jesus Beating, Torture Chamber, you know, Collision Course, Six Pack Challenge, you name it, man. We've been a part of some huge things.
We've been part of a lot of. Yeah.
And it's pretty exciting to see guys like Taylor who have been part of Supercards, but never something to the level that 100 Show is going to be.
Right.
See what they can do and step up. You know what I mean? When the spotlight and the ball's in their hands.
Right.
You know.
I mean, with balls in their hands, as long as they can carry them, that's what matters.
Yeah, exactly. What? Oh my god, it's a move that doesn't involve nipples.
I know, right? That is so true. Look at that. A version of a hip toss without nipples. And a weird lock there.
He's trying to get it into the crotchal area.
I'm telling you, Backyard, he's started some newer stuff, which is about fucking time.
Yeah, Backyard, as I said before, the most decorated champion in WWE history. He won the most championships. He has 7 under his belt. Nothing to knock at, you know?
Right.
I mean, I know you and Dawson are breathing down his neck real close there, though.
I'm pretty excited of having the opportunity to have won the hybrid title.
That makes you, we've won 6 championships, 2 heavyweight, tag team, pure vitality, supreme, and hybrid, so.
Hey, I'm in that run, too.
Yeah, Bouncer's won, yeah, Bouncer's at 5. Oh. Yeah!
Bouncer's not
Oh! Oh, it's magic, you know.
Bonzo's nowhere near that, but
that's,
you know,
a big man doing an enziguri right there. I'll never get over the fact that Taylor's just so agile.
Some stuff in the ring again. Take that belt from me real quick.
Why would I want to step in the ring with you? You ain't even on my level.
Oh, doo doo. Jerry Springer.
All right. You think so?
Yeah, I knew.
He wasn't saying that last time.
Oh, spear? Nope. Oh, flying forearm. I really thought he was going for a spear right there.
We'll talk about that. You had a cheek to win that match.
I did.
Oh, guys.
Marijuana smoke to give you a little power.
Hey, man.
Hey, hindsight is 2020, guys. Let's all watch Care Bears get high. Come on. What?
That was a good flying clothesline, man. Let's get back to the match before I have to.
Do you think the Care Bears actually get those tattooed on their body?
I think they do.
Uh-oh. Essence Killer. Uh-oh.
Hey, back right there.
Oh, backbreaker.
Backbreaker. Yeah.
That works for backbreakers. Oh.
Oh, it was a nice backbreaker. I remember the last one of the art shows, I tried to do one and totally messed it up.
It's all good. The Law Show.
Right.
I can't believe we had a show named that. That's awesome.
That was a good show too, by the way.
Yeah, man. Well, there are two heavyweight title changes in the same day. I don't think that's ever happened before. One that will live in infamy.
You're right on that.
Uh-oh.
Hopefully that
trying to hit that
again.
F5.
Couldn't quite get it.
Backyard with some form of a European uppercut. Probably one of the smaller countries we've never heard of.
Well, I mean, look, he's definitely dressed in his African ways. You know, he's probably from the Congo, maybe from the Sudan.
We should get to see his birth certificate.
Right. He's probably a gorilla, and not a gorilla, but
no non-American can be the heavyweight champion in this league. If Bobby Otis found out about that, he'd be pissed.
He's probably one of them African rebels.
Rebel? From Modern Warfare 3.
Right. I mean, look at him. It's a top ripoff, minus the knee pads. You know what he uses the knee pads for?
Blowing me. Blowing money.
Blowing money.
Throwing money and blowing money.
You're right. He loves blowing money.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah.
No.
What?
What did that bounce?
Well, yeah, what did you say?
I think he just took my move.
Oh, he took your move?
Well, what are you going to do about it, Bouncer?
Yeah, what are you going to do about it?
You don't interfere in people's matches. You live by a code. Bouncer lives by a code, everybody, code, guys. Right. He lives by code.
Don't be funny of the code.
I ain't making fun of the code.
You're back in the ring now.
We ain't making fun of your whack code, man.
Hey. Well, I'll make sure after my next match to hop the fence and get the fuck out of here so I don't get beat down. Two right here.
You're lucky, brother. I didn't expect that to give you powers.
Well, now you know.
I ain't even gonna get mad. That was good. But is that gonna happen the next time? I don't think so.
Come on, guys. You both got your own titles and your own things to worry about. Let's focus on this match here.
Yeah, I will. Let's focus on the match. You got a reversal here.
Duck the clothesline.
Oh!
Love that jumping sidekick he does. That's a nice little jumping sidekick.
Right into the intestines.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, he's picking him up. What's he going for? For the
F5.
F5? Oh, he got him. He got him. He connected it. Man, all he's got to do is pin him, and he's got this. All he's got to do is pin.
Blackheart has a built-in roll, like he has a death streak. And like Call of Duty, like, so he just starts rolling when he gets hit with a finisher. What?
One, two.
Foot on the rope, man. Foot on the rope.
Foot on the rope, man. Foot on the rope. It looks like the referee did not notice.
Ref, get a job. Get a real job.
We're not ringing the bell. Foot on the rope.
Turn up.
That's right, man.
His foot was on the rope, man.
Hold on, what's going on here? Hold on.
Replay.
Instant replay, son.
His foot was on the rope.
I guess we got the replay.
Keep it going.
I guess Taylor's noticing that we got the replay rule. What's going on? Our referee here noticed what's going on.
Get your hands off me. I ain't no referee.
Oh man, Taylor just made a mistake there.
What the fuck? He hit it.
Quick
play his music now.
Backyard is a winner.
Wow, that was crazy. I guess nowadays we have the replay rule here.
That's right. We got a black commissioner now.
Oh.
WMWA fans, fellow wrestlers, anybody who's ever watched, I know who Rush is, or, WMWA in general. You saw my return today. 14 months of being out of the ring, I gotta tell you, coming out there and getting cheered and all that great stuff was felt really good. You know, it was an awesome experience, and the fans appreciate me, and that's why I need to address this thing. I've been quiet ever since I laid down as commissioner and let FDL take over. I've been watching WMWE transpire, and it's amazing some of the things that are going on to the Hunter Show with Dawson and Drake. And Big C getting outsmarted by Angel, I don't understand that, but especially with Angel, I don't know what's going on there with his sexual stuff where he's got to touch people and smack people's asses. Angel, just come out and say you're gay, okay? Like, you're so far in the closet, you suck dick in Narnia. So, I mean, just come out and get it over with already. And my boy, one of my best friends of all time, Backyard at the Hunter Show, will be wrestling in a casket match against Anarchy, who we have not seen in a while. And I don't know what's going on with him, but that bitch needs a new mask, for sure. And he needs to get his act together, because this coming out and flailing around like you're a Teletubby, Backer's going to wipe the floor with you if you don't get your act together. Just letting you know now. And I look forward to seeing great kids in TaylorMade and CJ Price, who I wrestled CJ for the first time, and that neckbreaker does not feel good. Those guys are going to have a great match, but getting to the 100 show now, running down some of my thoughts on other people, what is Rush going to do with the 100 show? I've been saving this for a while, and the first thing that ever happened to me in WMWA was I was overpassed early on by Justin Moore. Justin Moore was a big name in ICW and SWAW, and he came back and he got to supersede me in my quest for the title. I was already a ranked guy. You know, I won a tournament for Genesis and all this other great stuff to earn title matches. He was given it, and me and Justin, long story short, have never seen eye to eye. But you know what? I've always respected his ability and his athletic skills. But my problem is, he just walked out on us. In 2010, he wins Match of the Year, wins the hybrid title, the inaugural hybrid title. And then we expect great things in 2011, and he's just gone. Justin Moore, are we just not good enough for you anymore? We were good enough for you for 6-7 years. I'm trying to figure out what happened. You just up and walk away with a title. You obviously knew you were wrestling for a title. You're planning on coming back. And the thing is, he doesn't even have the balls to say why. He didn't say, I retired, I'm done, I can't do it anymore. He just up, left, said fuck you, and never came back. You know what, Justin Moore? You betrayed us. And at the 100th show, I don't care what I got to do beforehand, but you're going to come out of retirement or whatever your state of mind you're in, and you're going to wrestle Rush. Because we've been one-on-one twice, and we are tied. And winning my match against you in Retribution 2010 was one of the biggest days of my career, and it launched me to greater things, and I did win the heavyweight title last year. So you can go to hell, Justin Moore, but before you do that, my backbreakers are going to send you there. I will break you in half at the 100th show, Justin Moore. So if you got any balls, you'll be there. And I promise you, if I don't get an answer before the 99th show next week, I will do something to you or somebody close to you that you will not appreciate. So just be a man for once. Just one time, be a man. Come back. Just announce it on the site, Facebook, wherever you want to announce it. You know, send me a text, man. I don't care. Just say yes. The 100th show, because people want to see that. One more time, you and me, Justin Moore.